Hi everybody, it's Sunki here. Take control and be happy every day. While I work as a pharmacist in a pharmacy, I help my patients cure acne, and many of my patients have successfully cured acne. And today, I would love to help you too. If you're watching this, you probably have pimples and acne problems, and it's really bugging you. I can totally understand that because I've been there. When I was in high school, my acne problem was serious. I have this bright red wall running across my forehead, and it was really bad. And when I mean wall, I really meant wall. I can't even spot anywhere that is not inflamed at all on my forehead. And I still remember needing to put makeup to school so it doesn't look that bad. Yeah, that was really an embarrassing moment of my life. I know how you feel. It feels terrible, painful, and it can chip away your confidence. So today, let's look at how to fix it. I will be covering a lot of information, and I will make sure that every second is worth your time. And wait, if you haven't already subscribed, please hit the subscribe button down below and the bell as well to be part of the family, as I'll be posting more skincare related and fun videos in the future. Now, without further ado, let's rock it. The most common acne is called acne vulgaris. It develops mainly on your face, neck, chest, shoulders, and upper back. Acne lesions can be divided into two types: the non-inflamed, like the whiteheads and the blackheads, and the inflamed ones, like the red and pussy filled pimples, nodules, and cysts. Acne forms when the bacteria called the Propionibacterium, aka P. acne, flourishes under their ideal growth environment. And what is their ideal growth environment? Lots of oil to eat and where there's no oxygen to breathe. So that's why you notice that many teenagers during puberty will have more of a chance of getting acne. That's because their sex hormones, androgen, causes the oil gland to produce excessive oil, and this actually creates food for peak acne. And on top of that, during puberty, the body gets rid of the dead skin cells at a higher rate. Combining with the excessive oil that is produced, this forms the plugs. The plugs will then clog the pores. Now, clogging the pores means that less oxygen can get into the pores, and this creates a great environment for P. acne to grow. Now, remember what we said about P. acne? They like to grow under places that has no oxygen. Now, if the plug stays under the skin, it's called whiteheads. If the plugs get pushed out of the skin, reacting with the skin's pigment called melanin, light and oxygen, it turns into black and it forms a blackhead. Blackhead is not dirt. And when P. acne and the excessive oil starts to irritate the clogged hair follicle, it triggers the body's inflammatory reaction, bringing all white blood cells to fight against acne, creating white yellow pus. And this is where a pimple is born. Now, besides puberty, acne can also happen to people at their older age as well, especially when they are under stress. Because when someone's stressed, the body secretes a type of hormones called the cortisol. Cortisol reduces the immune system, thus reduces the ability of the body to fight acne. Acne problem can be also due to genetic as well. Everyone has P. acne on their face, but for some people, they overreact with P. acne. Thus, the body continuously bringing in all the inflammatory reaction, trying to fight against the very little P. acne that many people don't care about. And this causes a never-ending redness and inflamed acne problem. For others, it can be because their white blood cells are incapable of killing P. acne, and it dies itself before even killing P. acne. And this is also going to continuously activate the inflammatory system, causing a never-ending redness and inflamed acne. Now, knowing how acne is formed, let's now see how we can fix it. Now, there are many products out there to treat acne. How do you know what to choose? Here, I've broken down the products to their main ingredients, and you can use it as a guide to help you choose the right product for yourself. I will be putting down links below for the products that I recommend for your convenience, so you can have a place to start. From there, tailor the products to best suit your needs. Now, there's no best skincare, but there is the most suitable skincare for you. Number one, Benzoyl Peroxide. This is the first line treatment for mild to moderate red inflamed acne. Benzoyl peroxide kills P. acne. There are many brands out there that contains benzoyl peroxide, like Oxy, Benzac, Clearasil, Neutrogena, and many more. It comes in different strengths, 2.5%, 5%, and 10%. Studies have shown that 2.5% is as effective as 10% without overdrying your skin. However, that claim actually comes from the product company itself. Personally, 2.5 to 5% does nothing for me. I need to use 10%. And I use the tinted Oxy cover 10%. It actually treats and covers my pimple at the same time. Now, if you don't like the tinted Oxy cover, I can understand because that tint might not suit your skin's shade. You can then use the Neutrogena Rapid Clear Stubborn Acne Spot Gel, which contains 10% benzoyl peroxide. When I initially used the 10% benzoyl peroxide, it actually really burnt my skin. But now it's fine. The skin actually adapts to it after a while. So if your skin is really sensitive, I recommend going for the 2.5% first. And if nothing happens to that, then step up to a higher concentration. Another great product that I use is the Neutrogena Rapid Clear Stubborn Acne Cleanser. I absolutely love it. It clears my skin really fast. The ingredient here is also benzoyl peroxide 10%. Number 2, Salicylic Acid based product. Salicylic acid breaks down the plaque, allowing oxygen to flow into the pore, creating less favorable environment for P. acne to grow. There are many products out there as well that has salicylic acid in it. Just to name a few, Neutrogena, Garnier, Clearasil, Oxy, and many more. Salicylic acid based product is used for milder acne when the acne is still at their white to black head stage. Salicylic acid can cause dryness and burn your skin as well. So you don't want to overload your skin with all salicylic based products all at once. For an example, using a salicylic acid based scrub followed by a salicylic acid treatment pads, and then use a salicylic acid toner, then use a salicylic acid based moisturizer. You know what? You might look like a tomato after that. So just pick one or two products and build it up from there. A combination I would recommend is using the Neutrogena Rapid Clear Maximum Strength Treatment Pads, or if you don't really like the idea of pads, use the Neutrogena Rapid Clear 2-in-1 Fight and Fade Toner. Either one of these is fine, and combine it with another non-pore clogging moisturizer such as Cetaphil. Now, Cetaphil is a hospital grade moisturizer. It is so gentle that it is often used for babies and acne prone skin. Now, please to use common sense while you're using these products. If it burns your skin, then reduce the frequency of use. Now, if acne occurs on your body, you can also use salicylic based acne body wash, such as the Neutrogena Body Clear Body Wash, and follow it up with the benzoyl peroxide spot treatment. Now, ladies, it is not very smart to put on makeup while you have acne, as it will further clog your pores and cause a never-ending cycle of acne. However, the great news is there are makeup products out there that is produced specifically for acne skin, and all of them actually contain salicylic acid. Some of the brands that I can think of is Dermalogica and Clinique. However, they can be pricey. So a cheaper option is Neutrogena Skin Clearing Makeup Range. They carry tinted moisturizer, liquid foundation, mineral powder, and concealer, and actually comes in different shades as well. Some people complain that Neutrogena makeup foundation coverage is not enough. If that's the case, try e.l.f. Their foundation is made specifically for acne-prone skin as well, and it actually gives a better coverage. Number 3, light therapy. Light therapy is FDA approved to treat mild to moderate acne. It is safe and uses a wavelength of blue and red light to treat acne without damaging the skin. The blue light kills P. acne and the red light reduces the redness. Light therapy also shrinks the oil glands in your skin, so your skin makes less pore clogging oil. If the benzoyl peroxide and salicylic acid irritates the skin, give this a go. Neutrogena has the light therapy. It comes in a pen and a mask. So you can use a pen for spot treatment and use the mask if the acne affects wider area of your skin. Now to see results, it takes anywhere from 1 to 12 weeks. And best results actually is seen after 12 weeks of use. So you really gotta be patient and persistent with this. Now you may ask, how about tea tree oil? The evidence for this is quite weak. It works for some, it doesn't work for some. For me, it certainly did not work. But if you want to give it a try, by all means. Now, if none of the above over-the-counter medication works for you, now over-the-counter means that medication that you can actually get without a doctor's script. Now, if that's the case, you would need to see a doctor to get a script for your acne treatment. Your doctor will assess your condition and prescribe the most appropriate treatment for yourself. Treatment that a doctor might prescribe are topical and oral antibiotics, retinoids, oral contraception for ladies, or even laser treatments. Make sure you talk to your doctor about potential side effects before you commence the treatment. One thing that's so important, which is if you are pregnant or likely to be pregnant, you must tell your doctor about it. Some prescription medications such as the Accutane is a category X in pregnancy, which means it will cause fetal abnormalities and should never be used if pregnant or likely to be pregnant. Now, there are very little scientific correlation between food and acne. However, if you notice eating certain food flares up your acne, just avoid it. Remember, dependent on the severity of your acne, it does take time to heal. So be patient, it's not going to be happening overnight. And for some people, acne actually gets worse before it gets better. This is because the treatment that you're using is actually fixing the future acne formation, and whatever lesion that you have already have now will continue to run its course. And for certain medications such as retinoid, how it works is it stimulates the skin cell turnover, removing all the skin cells that are clogging your pores. Now, as the skin cell turns over, sometimes it brings up inflammation and causes acne to flare up. So for some patients, your doctor would actually suggest to use laser or light-based therapy to avoid initial flare-up to speed up the improvement of your acne. But this is for you and your doctor to decide. Now, what I'm trying to bring across is actually acknowledging that acne does get worse before it gets better for some people can actually stop you from hitting the panic button before allowing some time for your acne to actually work its course to heal with the treatment. So bear that in mind. However, if you're concerned, if your skin is flaring up and burning, seek medical advice. Talk to your doctor about it. Your doctor might adjust the dosage of your treatment. He might ask you to wait or change the whole treatment altogether. So yeah, don't keep it to yourself. Seek professional advice. Now let's talk about things that might make acne worse. These are things that you want to avoid doing. Number one, some skincare and haircare products actually increases the amount of oil on your skin, such as oil-based makeup, hair oil, suntan oil, and oil-based sunscreen. So if you do use sunscreen, make sure you pick a non-comedogenic sunscreen. Comedogenic means pore clogging. Non-comedogenic means non-pore clogging. I recommend using the Neutrogena Clear Face Liquid Lotion Sunscreen for acne-prone skin. That is non-pore clogging. Number two, working with oils and greases can increase the amount of oil on your skin, such as frying food. So if you like to eat fried food, you might want to ask someone else to fry it for you. And also one thing, your oily phone screens where you place your face while talking to someone might cause acne to get worse. So if your phone is oily, make sure you clean your phone screen first before you use it. And number three, mechanical scrubbing, scratching, squeezing, or picking your pimple is a no-no. You're risking it getting worse as it might get further infected and leave scars. So be careful with scrubbing pads, loofahs, electric brushes. They can actually cause tiny skin tears on your skin and causes the irritation and more inflammation to happen. So if you want to exfoliate, stick to only once or twice a week. Now, if your acne is trending towards the whitehead and the blackheads, not too much red flaring pimples. Salicylic Acid Daily Scrub products can be suitable for you. Neutrogena Oil-Free Acne Face Wash Pink Grapefruit Foaming Scrub can be suitable. Number 4. Washing your face too often. Don't fall for the myth that acne is due to hygiene reasons and start to wash your face many times a day. Because what that will do is to strip down natural oil on your face and tells your body to create more oil to compensate that. And this makes your pimple worse. So I would just stick to the twice a day cleansing routine, the morning and the night. Number 5. Pressure from tight fitting clothes, headbands and chin straps can actually cause acne to get worse. Of course, we're talking about acne around your head, if you have a headband, chin straps, and also on your body. Number 6. High humidity. You might want to use a dehumidifier if you live in a place where there is high density of water in the air, such as a tropical country. Number 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 are hormonal changes such as menstruation, pregnancy, stress, anxiety, illnesses, and certain medication can also cause acne to get worse. Now, what type of medication causes acne? You need to speak to your doctor or pharmacist to verify that. I'm not going to tell you here because sometimes that medication is a life-saving medication. So you don't want to be trying to treat your acne and stop that medication. Thus, you need to seek professional advice. Talk to your doctor to weigh out their benefit and risk ratio and work it out from there. Now, today I've covered a lot of information. Please rewatch this if you need to. I put down the links of the products that I've recommended to you down below so you can start treating yourself ASAP. Now remember, it's a start. Remember to tailor the product selection along the way. There is no best product, but the most suitable product for yourself. Now all the best. Let me know if you have any questions and leave a comment below. Share with us if you have any other tips that works for your acne. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so, so you can find me again when you need this piece of information. And also come and join the family. Now, if you find value in this video, please give it a thumbs up. It will be much appreciated. It's Sunki here. Take control and be happy every day. With lots of love, see you next time. Bye-bye.